the wide world of sports is going on in Washington, D.C. I'm sorry for yelling. I'm not yelling at you. I'm not mad at you. I think you're great. North Carolina Republican Congressman Madison Cawthorn raising some eyebrows for dishing some hot gossip. Cawthorn recently appeared on a podcast to shed light on his experiences in D.C. He said this.
Being kind of a young guy in Washington, with the average age is probably 60 or 70. And I look at all these people, a lot of them that I've looked up to through my life, always paid attention to politics, guys that, you know. Then all of a sudden you get invited to, like, well, hey, we're going to have kind of a sexual get-together at one of our homes. You should come. And I'm like, what did you just ask me to come to? Yeah. And then you realize they're asking you to come to an orgy.
Yeah.
Or the fact that, you know, there's some of the people that are leading on the movement to try and remove, you know, addiction in our country. And then you watch them do, you know, a key bump of cocaine right in front of you.
Like where? Like who was it? Sounds like my prom night. Now, his colleagues in the House, they are not happy. Among them, House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy, who apparently met with Cawthorn today. McCarthy claims Cawthorn admitted exaggerating the story. Is D.C. really channeling House cards, or is it really closer to Veep? If all this is true, should the congressman name names? And if so, do you think they want a party? The party panel is back. Abby Hornacek, Kevin Walling, and Sean Tima. So, Abby, I will start with you. He should name names for a number of reasons, mostly because I'm incredibly curious to see who parties in D.C. Your thoughts?
Well, Kennedy, you and I had very different prom nights, by the way. But yeah, he absolutely should provide the names. I mean, that's the most logical thing here, right? I mean, I couldn't come on your show and say Kennedy only went to UCLA because she couldn't get into USC. It might be true. It might not be true. But I better be holding the rejection letter right here.
Why are you wearing UCLA colors if that's true?
I wanted to make you feel better for not getting into USC.
I never would have applied to that garbage school.
Oh, man, I'm outnumbered here. But yeah, I think Scott Perry said it best. He said, if you're going to make these claims, you got to name some names. I think the senior Republicans played this well. They were like, they went full parent mode and they were like, we're going to have a little chat with you and you're going to tell us exactly what happened. Apparently, the cocaine allegation came from him maybe seeing a staffer from like 100 yards away in a parking garage. So yeah, I think if he's going to malign a whole political party with his comments, he's got to be able to back that up.
Absolutely. Especially if you're a sitting congressman and you're talking about other people who hold office as you do. So yeah, I would seriously like to know who that is, because as a libertarian who hosts a libertarian show, I will tell you this, congressmen and women, we do not pass judgment and we really want to know what goes on there. So Kevin, who has the better coke-fueled orgies, Republicans or Democrats?
That's a very good question. You know, to your point, I really want to know names, too, because I live here in D.C.
Yeah.
I want to know where the party's at. And I can guarantee you, if this is true, and I think he already admitted that it was exaggerated a bit, it's not Democrats that are hanging out with Madison Cawthorn. I can almost guarantee you it's Republicans within his own caucus that are fueling this effort. So to your question, maybe it's the Republicans in their 70s, as he suggested, that are throwing these cocaine-fueled sex parties.
Yeah.
And sign me up.
I got no plans tonight. They have a very,
hit me up, Madison.
Very fueled caucus if 70-year-olds
exactly right.
are
That's
doing...
one way to win the midterms. They're all running around with a lot of energy.
They sure are. Woo! I've been up since 8:30 yesterday morning. God, I love America. So, Sean, do you think he's lying? Is it wishful thinking? Is it like, you know, the kid who makes a big story is like, yeah, my dad punched a giant this weekend and they gave him a medal?
Well, look, Kennedy, I lived in D.C. for 3 years, and the most I can tell you, the craziest thing I ever got invited to was Sunday brunch. And I would get seriously caffeinated there, but I was not part of this big club if it exists. Now, I do think the reason, though, and let's remember, the people like McCarthy, I think they're mad at Cawthorn more than anything because he's challenging the narrative that these D.C. politicians are these demigods who can do no wrong and that they're better than you and me. I mean, many of them, they run on being a servant to the common man. Mm. But the reality is, when they're in office, they got three priorities: get reelected, get elected to higher office, and make some money off insider trading. So they're not special people. And when the American people wake up to realize that, we can do a better job at holding them accountable and voting them out. But is it true? I don't know. I can't say. I wish I could say.
I know, man. I've spent plenty of time in D.C. I've never been invited to a Coke-fueled orgy. And I don't know if it's because I'm the loud, weird one that no one really wants the party because I'll be the buzzkill. I'd like
narc.
To at least see.
Narc.
I'm the narc.
Spot you from a mile away.
I'm going to be on the phone with DC police going, this is disgusting. Do you know what's happening here? This
and they
is,
won't
this
show
is
up
not domestic booger
police.
Sugar. This is from South America. Build the wall. Click. All right, well, let's move on to Will Smith. He is also in deep yogurt, officially under investigation for leaving his Fresh Prince on Chris Rock's face. But not by police. He's under investigation by the Academy of Motion Pictures, Arts, and Sciences. Yes, the Academy of Circle Jerks tonight announcing it has begun disciplinary hearings on the actor for violating their code of conduct during Sunday's ceremony. They also revealed that Smith was apparently, quote, asked to leave and refused. So what should his punishment be, if anything, Abby? How should they punish him?
What should his punishment be? I think maybe they make him dress up in his genie costume and go to Times Square in the middle of summer and take pictures for free with all of the crazed fans. I think that would be a suitable punishment. But, you know, I'm glad that the Academy clarified this because when this story first came out, it seemed like they had let him stay. And I'm like, you know, if you go to an NBA game and LeBron gets heckled by a fan and walks off the court and slaps the fan across the face and isn't ejected immediately, that would never happen, right? And so everyone was like, shame on the Academy. So I guess they did ask him to leave. I don't know at what point do you... Like, you're not going to use physical force to make him leave. So we'll see what happens, but I think that might be a suitable punishment.
How do you not leave when you're asked? I mean, I don't know if I believe the Academy. Like, we asked him to leave. He just wouldn't. So, like, what are we supposed to do? We're only the Academy. The LAPD was there. If you want the guy to leave and he assaulted someone, you say, hello, LAPD. Please escort this man out of the building. Do you buy that story? They asked him to leave and he refused, Kevin?
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I'm asked to leave oftentimes from public spaces, and I always comply. So I don't know. I think there, we have more answers, more questions than answers, obviously. And I think, as I saw, they're meeting in like 2 weeks, I think, this board of governors of the Academy.
Ew.
I think his punishment should be that he has to host the Academy Awards for the next 10 years and force him to stand there in front of all of his colleagues. After doing that that performance that we saw on Sunday.
Yeah, and he's got to do the Billy Crystal song parodies, too, just to make
that.
James Corden jealous. Like, gosh, I've got a better Broadway voice than he does. He didn't even apologize to Chris Rock personally. Chris Rock's brother, Tony, Sean, is like, yeah, he didn't even call my brother. Kind of a jerk move. I'm really not a Will Smith fan this week, Sean. Really not.
Mm. Yeah, well, I'm not either. You know, the... A wise poet once said, give them bread and circus and they will never revolt. Mm-hmm. I think that was Amy Schumer who said it. Don't quote me on it.
No, she ate
but,
all
you
the
know,
bread.
We got to remember. These... yes. But these, you know, these bread and the circus, these antics, it's a distraction from some of the real problems we got going on. And so it's fun to laugh at these celebrity dramas, but we got to make sure that we're not losing sight of where we can make a real difference and a real impact, or else we'll all just forget about the fact that inflation's through the roof and that we got a war in Ukraine that nobody wants.
No one's going to forget about that, Sean. No one's forgetting about the important things.
Thank goodness.
We can talk about the dumb things, too, because that's what people are actually talking about. But I will give you this. No one watches the Oscars. It was the second lowest broadcast in history until the slap because people are sick of getting lectured to by people in a Hollywood fart bubble who haven't spent any time with business owners and moms and dads and real people who have to work their asses off to make ends meet whose lives are being railroaded by the federal government. All of those people that Abby referred to at the beginning of the show, the independents, those are the people who hate the lectures. And that's why film and the Academy Awards are imploding, because no one cares anymore. No one wants to sit around and hear a lecture from someone who doesn't have control over their own emotions, and they give in to a little bit of anger, and they assault someone else on live international TV as though that's the best answer, and then the apology the next day is like, there's no room in this world for violence. It's like, yeah. Last night, the only thing there was to you was violence. So eat it, suck it, chew on it sideways, and don't give me lectures about anything. And we all know that inflation is really bad. All right, Abby, do you want to say anything else? Because I've talked for a long time.
That was beautiful. That's I mean, I don't know if I can top that. But yeah, I think that the Academy could definitely handle this better, and we'll see. I'm gonna go out to Times Square after the show, see if Will Smith is there.
If he is, don't hug him, because all the characters in Times Square in the costumes, the Elmos and the SpongeBobs, they all have bed bugs. All right, panel, thank you so much, Abby, Kevin, and
Sean. Good
advice. That's right. Heard it here first. Coming up, the government spying on you still. One Republican lawmaker just introduced a bill to stop all the snooping. Will it work? Will he have the backing? Utah Congressman Chris Stewart joins me in moments.